Welcome to the fifth evening of 7 of 7 2021, Performance and Live Art Festival curated by Myymälä2. Before introducing today's artist, I will briefly mention our lineup for the rest of the week. On Saturday, 15th, we have Roi Vaara, and on Sunday, the 16th, we have Saija, Alexandra, Kangasniemi. Today, we begin with the performance of Laura Cemin. Thank you.
Thank you. Is it over or is it on? Still on. Is it below? No, under. Under, below, beneath, underneath. Under, below, beneath, underneath. Under, below, beneath, underneath. Is it a carpet or a rug? I thought it was an elephant. Thank you. Hi, Wilhelmus. Thanks for coming and thanks for watching. I have some notes here that I would like to share with you. And if you are at home and you want to lay on your carpet, please feel free. So last month I moved to a new apartment, a completely empty, unfurnished apartment. So empty that my words would echo when spoken in it. You just need a carpet. The dealer said, it will do the trick. And so I signed a contract. The morning after, I received 4 phone calls by different companies that wanted to send me electricity and or internet connection. I'm trying to tell you that the only thing I need is a carpet. Can you help me? No one seemed to take my concerns seriously. I should have played their voice in speakers and let the reverb speak for me. And so I ended up the morning with a bloated liver, yet still without a carpet. At the beginning of 2000s, in Italy was still fairly common to receive offers to buy rugs and carpets over the phone. I remember every adult in my family struggling to find an effective strategy to slip out of such calls, avoiding rudeness or anger. With the exception of Elettra, my grandmother, who had a standardized answer which proved to be foolproof. I am allergic to dust, she would simply say. Then a pause. I would listen to those calls from behind her back, not to hear what the two speakers would actually say, but for that specific pause. The silence on both sides of the line, A mixture of surprise and shame, perhaps guilt, for wanting to sell a potentially dangerous article to a customer. The potentiality of everything that could have been said, but was never really voiced. How many chances can a silence hold? My grandmother is not allergic to dust, and she has never been. I've asked her. However, I've never seen a rug in her home. On the other hand, my brother is very allergic to dust. This is why he also never had a carpet in his room. Dust is, by definition, matter in fine, powdery, dry particles that lurks in the fibers of a rug. Dust is, by definition, composed of 50% of dead skin that archives in the fibers of a rug. My brother sneezes every time he inhales dust. This is why my mother had to store all his toys in the freezer. My mother sneezes every time she feels the air move, every time a door opens, or the window, or the freezer. Yes, she sneezes very often. Her sneezes come always in a row, in multiples of three, each sneeze at the same distance from the previous to the next, precise as a metronome. Conversing with my mother is like filling in the blanks on a grammar test. Every sneeze is a long line, a loud gap, a word turned silent, an open space for possibilities. A woman, a sculpture, and a man in an art gallery is not the beginning of a joke, but simply how we met. While walking around, you stopped for a moment and you looked at me, looking at you, looking at me, looking at a sculpture on the floor that was looking back at us, when you said, rock. You said, rock. And I heard rug. It looks like a rock, you said. It looks like a rug, I heard. And so I tried to see a rug in it, even if, you said. And so we looked at a thing, thinking about two different things, thinking that we were thinking about the exact same thing. And we went on, talking about a rock rug, talking about the same thing, having something else in mind. And even if so many misunderstandings appeared on the way, we still managed to have a conversation about the thing that for you was a different thing than it was for me. 2 days later, I received a picture with the caption "Finnish rock." I asked you about the difference between a carpet and a rug. You're a native speaker, but you didn't have the answer. And so I asked word reference instead. Carpet, noun, countable. A heavy fabric, commonly of wool or nylon, for covering floors, fixed from wall to wall. Rug, noun, countable. A movable piece of thick fabric for covering part of a floor. Older slang, to cut a rug, to dance vigorously. But now I wonder why Aladdin called his friend a magic carpet then. I'm pretty sure I remember dancing freely all around the golden cave. Maybe he didn't know the difference. Maybe he didn't remember the right word. Or maybe it's just a poor translation. month ago I thought about writing a lecture on the carpet. Why? It's hard to tell. But now I read it as a premonition. Soon after, the notice of moving came, and with it, apartment ads. In my mail, in my feeds, and soon after in my dreams. With closed eyes, I began to see nothing but rooms a little bit too small, with an incredible amount of things in them. Massive sofas, giant screens, king-size beds, a bathtub with a fountain, a piano and a trumpet, a shower with two curtains and a fryer and a fan, two seat markers and a note, shopping list on the counter, moving boxes and a marker, a scissor and a stone. Was it marble? A dishwasher on the table, a boiler with no cables, a bookshelf with some fables, curtain birds on the floor, moss on tiles, screws and drills, soil not water, metal trays, coffee stains, curtain rails, window sills, two high ceiling, two low drawers, folding tables, folding chair, tumble hair, head, face, still on your head. All too stuffed. And so I became insomniac. One night when sleep finally took over, I dreamt about an entirely empty room with no perceivable walls or ceiling. How do I know that such space was actually a room? It's still unclear, but I'm pretty sure it was one. To be precise, the room was not actually completely empty, but filled with bold characters resting on the floor, as confetti after carnival. A flaky, wordy ground. Every year in the United States, approximately 38,000 adults report injuries due to unfastened carpets and rugs, mainly in the bathroom. In my dream, the room was surely not a bathroom, but I managed to sleep nevertheless. Words always trip me up. The morning after, while sitting on the toilet, I found a purple dot on my right leg, and bathroom mat was crossed out from my shopping list. I dreamt about that specific room just once, but I also have a recurring dream in which I'm falling from a tree, belly down. I wonder what Mr. Freud would have said about it, but I avoid asking Siri for an answer. My new apartment floor is very smooth, and I enjoy to slide across it. But I fell already twice. I bought some rubber net with the wish to feel more stable there, but it didn't really help. I read that dreams tell us what we already know, just not in words, but through an image. Maybe Sigmund would have said, "You're a very slippery person." Thank you.
the name of a dance. Originated in the northern region of Cuba, that became internationally popular in the early 20th century. The term comes from Spanish and means to dance vigorously, to have a good time. It is danced with a basic pattern of two quick steps sideways and one slow forward. The music in 4/4 time tempo is known for its insistent syncopation. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Until a couple of years ago, Area 51, the American military base, was only a blurry rectangle on Google Maps. It looked like a hole, a place filler box without the lorem ipsum text in it. No information, no connotation. To date, the satellite image of Area 51 is visible online, but there are still almost 100 foggy squares spread all around the flat world. Holding secrets, hiding problems. I always thought the word Roomba meant a dance, until a friend sent me a map of her new apartment, screenshotted from her phone, made by her robotic vacuum cleaner. It is an image in two colors, all white and turquoise blue. It is an image in two colors, with an empty light square in the upper left corner. A suprematist pixelated painting, signed by her Roomba. It must be a glitch, I thought. A hole, an unexplored territory in the landscape of what is knowable. No information, no connotation. It must be a scary place, I thought, if the Roomba didn't go there. Those are very smart machines. Roombas are advertised as able to pick up an amazing amount of dirt, dust, pet hair from the carpet. But in reality, they prefer swimming all around the squares with suspicions. My friend kept her Roomba mainly for the company, because in a month it had already cut all her rug fringes. She calls it my little dancer. Such name was found in the catalog, but we have 24 other things to introduce to you. Alvin, Emten, Helleste, Hodde, Ipske, Höge, Lanste, Len, Lindknut, Björn, Lohals, Morum, Rodelund, Rörke, Sindan, Sörtsö, Sporo, Stoense, Tiphede, Toftov, Tuvelse, Verbak, Bindung, Bondsbank. From www.ikea.com/gb/m/search/products/2021. Question mark U equals magic plus carpet. C one day brought home 1,000 pieces of a landscape full of snow. A white, desolated landscape with no real details. Why? I do not know. I call it masochism. The last day of its reconstruction, the 1,000th piece couldn't be found, of course. Lost in the fibers of the furry carpet. We even masked the vacuum cleaner with a stocking and we acted as Ghostbusters. But it didn't really work. While laying horizontally looking for the missing, I found, however, many other things under the sofa, tangled with dirt and hair, in the darkness of what I had forgotten. But nothing that could really fit the image. I wish I could remember the experience as revealing. Dust and time tend to make everything more glowy after all. But it wasn't so. After processing the loss, the picture was hung as planned, with a golden frame around it, but a hole at its center. Such uncertitude seemed unbearable at first. But then time passed, laziness arose, the void became a habit, and we stopped looking for the missing. Browsing. While looking for a carpet that could eat away the echo, an ad appeared to me. A promotion for a rug with an image printed on. The elegance of a rug with the coziness of a carpet, it said. An image of some marble plus the fringes. Carpet that pretends to be a rock is just silly, I thought. But a rock that pretends to be a carpet is slightly heartbreaking. lying there camouflaging with the environment, in the search for a warm touch, for proximities of bodies. We go for a walk in Eira because I want to see the water. It just rained. You try to roll the R in Eira as I do it, but it's okay to sound different, I tell you in your own words. Together we speak your language. Eira, 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 Ora, Lora. Lora in my language means the hour, the time. It is screamed out loud to the neighbors just to know what time is it. Era Lora is a sigh of tired accomplishment, a release of the shoulder. Finally, you say, it was about time. It is always about time. On time, same time, spare time, same time, no time, time to leave, goodbye. You ask me, Lora, but you don't care about the time, you want my attention. Lora is my name for you, my name in your mouth with the R laying flat. You say the sky looks closer to the sea in Scandinavia. I do not think it's true, but the clouds are good at cheating, shifting shapes to make us wonder. In 1984, Roger Calliois wrote about legendary psychasthenia, the ability of some animals, like chameleons, for instance, to alter their appearance in response to the physical environment. He presented camouflage as a practice of blending in, not only an essential survival strategy, a mode of finding pleasure in dissolution. The chameleon effect is a classic linguistic phenomenon. Speakers, mainly foreigners, tend to imitate another person's gesture, body position, head tilt, and accent to be considered part of a group, to be liked by the speaking partner, an innate push to fit the landscape. While you look at the sky, I look at the rocks, and I think about geologists. Studying movements that they will never even see. While you look at the sky, I look at the rocks, and I think, how comforting must be to move in such slow motion. When you look at the sky, I look at a wet rock, but we actually see the same thing. A puddle as a cover, a reflection is a costume, a cloud is a mirrored image, and the rock starts to float. Some days after a volcano erupts, I spend hours looking at the lava flowing, finding its new place in slow motion. This page was intentionally left blank. Thank you.